Hi there, Miss Barber here. This lesson is titled Arguments and Truth Tables. Let's begin by getting some definitions. An argument consists of two parts, the premises, which are the initial or given statements, and the conclusion, which is the resulting statement. We call these symbolic arguments because we generally express statements in symbolic form to determine its validity. An argument is valid if the conclusion is true whenever the premises are assumed to be true. If the argument is not valid, then it is invalid or fallacious. The structure of a formal argument. A formal argument consists of three parts, a premise one, a premise two, and a conclusion. Let's look at an example. Premise one, if aliens invade the earth, then we are doomed. Symbolically, that's an if-then statement. If P is aliens invade the earth and Q is we are doomed, then symbolically it would be P, right arrow, Q. Premise two, aliens invaded the earth. Symbolically, we would write just Q. And the conclusion is, therefore, we are doomed. Symbolically, therefore, Q. To write, if aliens invade earth, then we are doomed. And aliens invaded the earth, therefore, we are doomed. We can write this symbolically as bracket. If P, then Q, and P, close bracket, right arrow, Q. This structure of the argument is called direct reasoning. Example, determine the validity of bracket, open parentheses, P, right arrow, Q, close parentheses, and P, bracket, right arrow, Q, with a truth table. This is read if FP implies Q and P, then Q. We have a truth table template for us with two columns completed. Under P, we have true, true, false, false. Under Q, we have true, false, true, false. Let's begin by constructing the truth values for the conditional if P, then Q. This we have by definition. Truth implies truth, that's true. True implies false, that's false. False implies true is true. And false implies false is also true. Now let's put that together with and P. That is, if P implies Q and P. We are looking at a conjunction, and with a conjunction, all parts or all simple statements have to be true. We have true and true, that would be true. However, all remaining combinations include a false. False and true is false. True and false is false. And true and false again is false. Now let's put that together for the entire direct reasoning argument. That is, if P implies Q and P, so all of that happens, then Q. So we're going to look at the fourth column truth values and then let that be the if. The then part would be Q. True implies true is true. False implies false is true. False implies true is true. And false implies false is true. The final column of this truth table is all trues. Thus, the argument is valid. Determine the validity of an argument with a truth table. Step one, use a letter to represent each simple statement of the argument. Two, express the premises and conclusions symbolically. Three, write a symbolic conditional statement in the form premise one and premise two and premise dot 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 n implies the conclusion. Step four, construct a truth table for the conditional statement of the previous step. And step 5, if the final column of the truth table is all truths, then that conditional statement is a tautology and the argument is valid. However, if the final column of the truth table is not all truths, then the conditional statement is not a tautology and the argument is invalid. Example, determine the validity of the following arguments. Part A, if aliens invade Earth, then we are doomed. Aliens have invaded, therefore we are doomed. Let's use a letter to represent each simple statement. I'll let P be aliens invade Earth, and Q be we are doomed. Then symbolically we would have, if aliens invade Earth, then we are doomed. That would be P implies Q. Guess what P happens? Then we can conclude, therefore Q. We've already worked with the standard form. This argument form is called direct reasoning and it is valid. This statement is valid. Part B. If the Rangers win the AL West, then the Rangers will win the World Series. The Rangers won the World Series. Therefore, the Rangers won AL West. We'll begin by assigning a letter to each simple statement. Let's let P be the Rangers win the AL West. Then Q would be Rangers will win the World Series. Symbolically, we need to put, if Rangers win the AL West, then the Rangers will win the World Series using the letters P and Q. That would be P implies Q. The next simple statement is the Rangers won the World Series, so that would be Q. And the conclusion we're drawing is, therefore, the Rangers won AL West. That's P. The argument structure, P implies Q, and Q, therefore P, can be written as bracket, and then in parentheses, if P then Q, and Q, close bracket, then P. We're going to use a truth table to determine the validity of this argument. We start with a template, two columns already completed, P followed by true, true, false, false, and Q, underneath it, true, false, true, false. Let's begin with the conditional, if P, then Q. The truth values for if P, then Q are, if true, then true, that's true. If true, then false, that is false. If false, then true, true. If false, then false, that is true. Now let's put that together with Q. We're going to have a conjunction. That would be if P implies Q and Q happens at the same time. When you're using a conjunction, every simple statement must be true in order for that conjunction to be true. So let's look at true and true, that's true. False and false, that's false. True and true, that's true. True and false is false. That becomes the premises. That is, if P implies Q and Q, that's the big if, we want that to say then P. Let's find the truth values for brackets, if P then Q and Q, close bracket, then P. So now we're looking at true implies true, that's true. False implies true, that's also true. However, in that third attempt, truth implies false, that is false. And false implies false, that's true. Notice that the last column is not all truths. The structure of this argument is called the fallacy of the converse, and it is invalid. Part C. If Karen graduates college, then she will be a success in life. Karen is not a success in life. Therefore, Karen did not graduate college. To proceed, let's assign letters to simple statements. I'll let P be Karen graduates college, and Q be she'll be a success in life. Now let's structure this symbolically. The first premise, if Karen graduates college, then she will be a success in life, is if P, then Q. The second simple statement, Karen is not a success in life. That would be the negation of Q. And the conclusion drawn here is therefore Karen did not graduate college. That would be therefore not P. This formal argument structure can be written as if P then Q and not Q then not P. We will construct a truth table to determine the validity. The template has two columns already completed. The first column is P, and the subsequent rows have true, true, false, false. The second column is Q, subsequent rows are true, false, true, false. Let's begin with, this time, not P. We negate the column of true, true, false, false, which will give us false, false, true, true. Now let's negate Q. That is not Q. So when you negate true, false, true, false, the opposite truth values would be false, true, false, true. Now let's do the conditional. P implies Q. By definition, we know that this column will be true, false, true, true. Now we can put some things together. If P implies Q and not Q. When you have a conjunction that's and, all simple statements must be true in order for that conjunction to be true. So now we are looking at true and false, that's false. False and true, that's also false. True and false, that's false. And the last one, true and true, would be true. That column is the big if. If P implies Q and not Q, then do we get not P? Let's do this if-then statement, and we will have F, F. That is, if F, then F, that's true. If F, then F, that's also true. If F, then true, that's true. And if true, then true, that is true. Observe that the final column, all entries are true. The structure of this argument is called contrapositive reasoning, and it is valid. Standard forms of arguments. We have four common standard forms of valid arguments. They are direct reasoning, contrapositive reasoning, transitive reasoning, and disjunctive reasoning. We also have four common standard forms of invalid arguments. They are the fallacy of the converse, the fallacy of the inverse, misuse of transitive reasoning, and misuse of disjunctive reasoning. Example, use the standard forms of arguments to determine the validity of the following arguments. Part A, if you pass pre-calculus, then you can take calculus 1. You pass pre-calculus. Therefore, you can take calculus 1. Our first step in determining the validity is to assign letters to each simple statement. Let's let P be you pass pre-calculus, and we'll let Q be you can take calculus 1. The first statement, if you pass pre-calculus, then you can take calculus 1, is an if-then statement, so structure would be if P, then Q. The second simple statement, our second premise, is you pass pre-calculus, so that would be P. It concludes, therefore you can take calculus 1, so therefore Q. The structure of this argument is direct reasoning, and we have previously proven with a truth table that direct reasoning is valid. Part B, if I voted, then it is an election year. I did not vote, therefore it is not an election year. We begin again by assigning letters to each simple statement. Let's let P be I voted. Then Q can be, it is an election year. Let's set this up for the structure of the argument. If, then. So it would be P, Q. If I voted, then it's an election year. The second statement I have is, I did not vote. So that would be
not P.
And the conclusion is, therefore, it is not an election year, which would be therefore not Q. This argument form is called the fallacy of the inverse, and therefore it is invalid. Part C. Either I will go for a run or I will go biking. I went for a run, so I did not go biking. Let's begin by assigning letters to each simple statement. I'll let P be I'll go for a run. Then Q can be I will go biking. Now let's put this in symbolic form. Notice that what's joining the first premise together is or, so I'll have P or Q. The second one is I went for a run, so that would be P happens. And the conclusion then is then I didn't go biking, so therefore not Q. This argument form is the misuse of disjunctive reasoning, and therefore it is invalid. Example, determine the validity of each argument. Part A, if I'm tired, then I'm edgy. If I'm edgy, then I'm mean. Therefore, if I'm mean, then I'm tired. Let's begin by assigning letters to each simple statement. I'll let P be I'm tired. I'll let Q be I'm edgy. And I'm going to let R be I'm mean. Now, let's put symbolic equivalencies for each of the written premises. For if I'm tired, then I'm edgy, we can have P implies Q. If I'm edgy, then I'm mean, we can have Q implies R. Now, therefore, if I'm mean, then I'm tired, symbolically we would have therefore. If R, then P. This looks like transitive reasoning, but notice the order of the transitions. We conclude that this argument is invalid because the form is a misuse of transitive reasoning. Part B. If Tim and Janet play, then the team wins. Tim played and the team did not win. Therefore, Janet did not play. Let's assign letters to each simple statement. I'll let P be Tim plays. Then Q can be Janet plays. And finally, I'll let R be the team wins. Now, let's express each of those English language statements symbolically. So for if Tim and Janet play, then the team wins, we can have if, and in parentheses, P and Q, then R. Tim played and the team did not win. Tim plays would be P, and the team not winning would be not R, so we would have P and not R. And the conclusion is, therefore, Janet did not play. Therefore, not Q. This argument is valid. See the truth table in your notes for the verification.